So my name is Jordan, as you guys already know, or a lot of you guys. I actually met Jeff at Cracker Barrel. I was freelancing for God's Not Dead 3, actually. And I met him, and one of the first things I told him was, I don't really do the whole church thing. I don't do all that. But shortly after that, he led me to the Lord at Starbucks, and I started coming to church here. And then shortly after that, I felt called to the ministry as well. And the struggle with that was being able to accept it. And after months and months of prayer and then talking to Jeff and more prayer, I finally was fully convinced that God was calling me, and I was accepted.
And you've been baptized in the believer's baptism?
Yes.
Very good. Thank you. Introduce yourself and tell us about your salvation and your call to the gospel.
My name is CJ Dennis, for those that don't know. I was saved young, I would say, probably 10 or 11 years old. Reading the Left Behind series, there's a little prayer in the end of every book. And, well, the books terrified me, truth be told, and I didn't want to be one that was left behind. And I started going to church every time the doors were open until I was about 14 years old. And after a while, I started to backslide. Met my wife about 10 years later or so, or actually 7 anyway. And then she's been coming here for a long time, came and started talking to Brother Jeff. I heard the first calling to preach when I was 14, and I didn't answer for a long time. It wasn't until after my cousin passed away and I led his funeral service that I couldn't not answer anymore. Shortly after that, I started talking to Brother Jeff. I was baptized here at Lifeline, and then I surrendered to the ministry shortly after that.
Very good. Tell us again your name and information about you and your salvation experience.
My name is T.L. Thacker. I was baptized and saved in 1974, and 50 years later, I'm still here.
Amen. And you feel like God's called you to be a deacon of the
church?
Yes.
Yes.
What led you to that belief?
By y'all being asked.
Good and simple with these guys.
I'm Craig Carney. I am the when I was ordained about 20 years ago at First Baptist Church, just right down the road. At that time, as I shared earlier, I'm the brother of a deacon, the son of a deacon, the grandson, great-grandson of Southern Baptist deacons. It's just in my blood, and it was a kind of ordained to be ordained. I am. I thought I had been saved when I was 10, as probably a lot of you. As I got older, I certainly wasn't living that kind of life and lifestyle. I got to dating a girl that I really liked, I thought I did, and she went to a youth camp. You wonder why I spend so much time with the youth, as I love it, and it is to a calling. And she came back from youth camp and broke up with me, and it just really crushed me. And I couldn't blame her. She said, "I can't live a double life like you are. I can't be one person." I was teaching a Sunday school class and certainly living like the devil on Saturday. And so I couldn't. She said, "I can't live with that." So I did something very unusual and strange. I went home and told my dad that something was wrong. He led me to the Lord. I lived in my parents' house, which is pretty cool. Pretty cool. And so I immediately got back with that girl and married her a few years later. She's still trying to make me right. I've been perfect ever since.
One of the requirements of the deacon is not to lie.
I'm Gary Tanner. One of my salvation stories would be the same thing as CJ. I grew up in the church my whole life. Kind of strayed away from it. Got saved when I was 12 years old. Got away from it for years until I found a wife. Finally left this church, and tonight I'm being ordained as a deacon. As Brother Jeff said, I don't know how many years, 2 years on, you're going to be a deacon one day. You make you a deacon, and here it
been second being hounded by Jeff. He's been telling me for years that one of these days I'm going to make a deacon out of you, and I told him to be careful what he wished for. Then when they had the council, I told him I must be desperate because I'm definitely not worthy of becoming a deacon. But I'm Rob Carr, in case anybody doesn't know me. My wife Whitney's over there, we have Lily and Kaylee. I think they're in the back. When I was a younger man, before I met my wife, I was raised in a different denomination. And when I grew up and moved out of the house, I knew that something was amiss in my life. And I knew that there was something else out there for my faith. And then when I met Whitney, she was with Jeff, and I met Jeff a couple of times and spoke with him. And he, with Whitney, led me to Jesus in his office. And that was 11 years ago. And becoming a deacon has not really been on my list of things to do. With all the stuff going on in our lives, being parents and homeowners and everything else we do, it hasn't really crossed my mind, even though Jeff is always telling me about it. But he approached me seriously about it, I don't know, a bunch of months ago, and told me to pray about it.
My name is Calvin Outlaw. My wife is Missy Outlaw. I have two kids, Colby and Morgan. My salvation pretty much started, I'd say, about 6-7 years ago, when I joined this church. For a long time, I didn't want anything to do with a church or anything God-related. We came here to visit this church, and I started feeling different about it for some reason. That week, after we joined the church, we're going to have a rainstorm, and I knew there was a hole in our roof that needed to be fixed. So I went up to go fix the roof, and as I was coming down, when I was done, I slipped off the ladder and fell. I landed on my foot and broke my heel. Later I was told that my head almost hit a brick on the ground. After that, I really felt at that point that I was saved by God and needed to do something else with my life besides running away from it. So that week we joined the church, and I've been trying to grow my life ever since.
Amen. Amen. Now, just keep that mic and I'll ask you the next set of questions. As a deacon of the church, these are, I want to say to you that the deacons would give me permission to talk to these guys about being deacons at the appropriate time. And with all of them at the beginning, with all of them, with the exception of Craig, because he served as a deacon, these four young guys said, absolutely not. I do not feel like that God wants me to be a deacon. Almost every one of them had a very similar story. And so tonight is a good night. It's an emotional night for them and for me, because I've watched all of these men grow. And I know that they've struggled this week. And almost every one of these guys have called me, if not once, two or three times, and asked me questions and told me I'm praying about this. Aren't you thankful that they've prayed about this decision? Because, gentlemen, I will say to you, outside of your own salvation and outside of your marriage, told in our ordination council, the word deacon means servant. And as I've read tonight from Acts chapter 6, you're to serve the tables, primarily to minister to the sick and to the widows, to serve in baptism and the Lord's Supper, the two ordinances of our church. And as you think about being a servant to the church, I want you to briefly tell us, why do you think God would want you to serve the church? Why do you think God would want you to serve the church? Because that's what you're going to be doing. These men that are ordained deacons and pastors will tell you that being a servant is not always a fun or desirable or comfortable or easy thing to do, especially you two that are going to be pastors. So why do you think that God would call you to serve Lifeline Baptist Church and God's people here? And as brief as you want to be, as long as you want to be, this is not a set up question, it's not a question you can get wrong. Why do you think God's called you to serve the church, beginning with your wife and your children? For you that are single, that praying for your future wife and children, if God wants you to have that. And if not, being single and serving in that way. Why do you think God wants you to serve this church? Calvin?
For me and my wife, I think, and my kids, I think God would want me to serve, help serve the church to help us grow in God's eyes.
Very good.
It's pretty simple for us. We're very blessed in many ways, and believe that to whom much is given, much is required. And for what we're blessed with, the graces that God has given me and Whitney, I don't think that I've been giving back enough to this church in any form of ministry. So I think that's that.
Servants, you know, always looking for opportunities to serve in the church. That was just the way I was raised. I don't know any better. It's I shared in a Sunday school class this morning. I teach that we were taught to do things without expecting anything in return, and that was just the way I was raised. So the duties of a servant as a deacon of a church, as I told this group when we started, I said, you know, I'm doing this. This is what I do. It's just my heart. And it's to serve, to help, to do what I can. And I failed to mention, I guess most of you probably know that Sherry is my wife over there, and everybody else is introduced to wife, and I don't want to get in trouble. and she's sitting with my daughter and my son, and I'm very proud of it. And my granddaughter. Y'all that have grandkids, y'all understand. For me personally, it's to get out of my laziness and to grow in the Lord.
Well, I too did introduce my wife and Megan over there, and my son Atticus, and my daughter Bella, and yeah, I'm probably in trouble. For Megan, it was, I'm sure there's a bit of reluctance. For anybody that's known me longer than 2 years, knows my past, they know my history. And to be here today is a blessing all in itself. I've always wanted to help people and to serve. I'm called for it. I
saved and I'm in the church, I found my calling with God to spread the gospel.
Amen. And all of you have already been asked that you believe that the Bible is the inerrant word of God. If you do, please say amen.
Amen.
If you do, please say amen.
Amen.
That's by the standard by which we do in our guidebook. And I want to say to you tonight that I'm proud of you, that I love you, and that all of our goals as Christians should be to grow. Now I'm going to open up the floor for questions from the congregation. If you have a question for any of these candidates, would you please rise and come to one of our microphones and ask your question? Any questions for any of these candidates? Any questions for any of the candidates? Okay. Guys, you're getting off easy. I have any. Okay, Ms. Vick, go ahead, come to the microphone. Josh, would you take her a microphone, please?
Observation as much as it is a question. Really, it's up there for all of us. But this question is especially directed towards Jordan and CJ. First of all, one of your biggest fans. Secondly, being that you are young in the ministry, you're the Timothys. Brother Jeff represents Paul in this case. How have you grown since you were first called to the ministry, since you've been licensed? And how will you continue to grow as young pastors in the ministry?
I would say in my own life, it has been through prayer. And what I mean by that is when I first started coming to church, I noticed, especially just people around me, that prayer was always sort of like that thing that you said you would do, and it was just like, I'll pray for you, or I'll pray for you about this, or whatever. And it wasn't really something that I practiced, and since being called to the ministry, I've been practicing prayer a lot, and that has transformed my faith, and that is, I would say, 95% of my relationship with God now is all through prayer, and I'll continue.
To build on what he said, and prayer to me is something I didn't do a whole lot of before, and I could pray more, but I definitely pray more than I used to. I read my Bible more. Once again, the Lord's still working on me. I have work to do, and that work will never be done, but I've come a long way to be a godly husband and a godly father, and I try a lot harder now than
good. Other questions from our congregation? If you're a pastor or a deacon, you have a question, please rise and ask that. We want these candidates to be questioned. Now, our council of deacons met with them earlier, and also our screening committee from the deacons met with them, or they wouldn't have gotten to the ordination council. So I do want you to understand that they've been asked a lot of questions. Anybody else have a question? We have Brother Clay and his wife with us, a young pastor at New Church. Brother Clay, Brother Joshua, to give you a microphone, and I just want you to just briefly tell them a little bit about what they may be in for, any observation that you have, please. And he had no idea I was going to call him. He should have, though, because I've always put him on the spot. Brother Clay?
Yes, so, so this was week four at our new church, so lots of wisdom to pass along. I think just being ready for everything, whatever it may be. fills you with that wisdom and guides you as those things come up. So.
Very good. Thank you, sir. Give him and his wife a hand. Bob's grandfather is also a Baptist minister. Where is he? I've lost him. Oh, here he is. Would you take him the microphone, please? Brother Josh, Rob's grandfather, right here. Go. And if you have any words of wisdom for these guys, we would like to hear from you. Any words of wisdom, comments, or questions right here. He'll give you the microphone.
Yes, I do. Very important. It's a very important position that you're taking. Tremendous responsibility. And you need to really understand that if I talk to you, or any of the people in your church, that's between you and them, God, not anyone else. And that's your first, to me, that's your first responsibility, is to want to help people that come to you. And be willing to do that. Doesn't make any difference what time of night it is, time of day. But you have a lot of responsibility. And don't take it very lightly. It's like being a pastor.
Like to ask.